Hey there, couples. Today we're starting a brand new series that, to be honest, we wish we didn't have to record. And you probably feel the same way if you found this video. The series is called After the Affair, and we want to help you think through how your marriage can survive an affair if that's where you find yourself right now.
And here's the tone we want to start with right off the bat. It's our series idea. Here it is. All hope is not lost after an affair if you're willing to work hard and forgive. So if you found this video and you find yourself in a situation where you've just discovered that your spouse was having an affair, or if you're the person who had the affair and you're thinking you've made a huge mistake and there's no turning back, we want you to know that with hard work and forgiveness and earning trust, your marriage can be saved and can even be better after you work through all of this stuff post-affair.
So in this first video, we're going to talk about finding hope after the affair, and you can find resources to have this conversation with a mentoring couple or just with your spouse at flextalk.org. Here's the image that we want you to become familiar with as we go through this series. We'll be talking to the offender on the one hand, the person who's had the affair, and then we're also going to talk to the offended, the victim, the person who is reeling from this news that you've probably just found out. And we'll be giving 5 steps for the offender in the next lesson. And then in the third lesson, we'll be talking about 5 steps that the offended person can take in order to really find hope in the midst of an affair. But for this video, we're just going to show you the final step for each of these two people. And let's start with the offender. You're really going to have to work hard to earn trust back.
Now, that might seem really obvious, but I want you guys to understand how paramount trust is to a healthy marriage, even if you've never had an affair. So for the offender, for the person that stepped outside of the marriage, who's had an affair with somebody else, brought somebody else into the marriage, it's just really important for you to know that your journey back to a healthy marriage with your spouse is going to be rooted in your ability to earn their trust, right? You've breached their trust. You've betrayed them in a major way. So your mindset for hope, right, for a marriage that can be restored, because it can, is going to have to be from a heart that you have to say, I'm going to do whatever it takes to earn my spouse's trust back.
Now, again, in the next lesson, we're going to give you the other 4 steps that you need to take as the offender so that you can begin to rebuild your marriage. But for now, we want to show the offended spouse that final step that you're going to have to take. And here it is. You need to be willing to extend forgiveness.
A trap that you don't want to get in is for you to think that the offender, your spouse, has all the work to do. They're the ones that cheated. They're the ones that breached trust. So they have all the work to do. I mean, yes, the offender has plenty of things that they're going to have to work through, different consequences that they have for their choices. But for the offended, if you want your marriage to be restored, if you want a healthy marriage, then one of the primary things that you're going to have to do is have a heart of forgiveness. A heart that's open to saying, you know what, that's been really hurtful to me, but I'm going to give room for you to earn my trust. And you're not going to be able to do that if you're resentful and bitter and just constantly throwing the mistakes in your spouse's face. You have to have the ability to forgive. That's the engine that gets things moving in a direction toward a healthy marriage.
So again, we'll fill out this picture over the course of the next 2 lessons. But for now, we encourage you to check out the discussion questions at flextalk.org and really sit down with a mentoring couple, sit down with your spouse, and start doing the hard work of finding hope after the affair.